Hello and welcome to High Voltages. From this video series, I am going to start a new tutorial series in which we are going to discuss Mqtt protocol, which is quite popular and lightweight IoT protocol. Beginning with the introduction, we will learn the implementation of Mqtt protocol with different boards, particularly ESP8266, ESP32, Arduino and Raspberry Pi. We will implement Mqtt in C++, Java, Python, Node-RED, and JavaScript programming languages, and also apply it in GUI, Android apps, and web apps. We will also learn to use Cloud Mqtt, AWS, PubNub, and other Mqtt available clouds. In these tutorials, I will also mention how to set up Mqtt broker locally using Raspberry Pi. So if you haven't subscribed, subscribe and press the bell icon to get a notification. Let's get started with the introduction of Mqtt protocol. Let's start with a brief history of Mqtt. Mqtt was developed in 1999 to monitor oil and pipelines over the satellite. And Mqtt is a lightweight protocol that performs well at unreliable networks. Mqtt is being used where bandwidth, speed, and battery life matters. For example, Facebook Messenger uses Mqtt connection and routing messages through their chat pipeline, and they can often achieve phone-to-phone delivery in the hundreds of milliseconds rather than multiple seconds. So let's see how this protocol works. There are four terminologies that you must know before going further: publish subscribe, messages, topics, and broker. Publish subscribe. The first concept is a publish and subscribe. A device will publish a message to a topic, and all the devices which are subscribing to that topic will receive that message. Messages. Messages are the information exchanging between devices in the form of command or data. Topics. That is the topic which you will subscribe to receive and publish to send data. Broker. The broker is the central part of the network and receives all messages, filtering them and decide who is interested in them and publishing the messages to all the subscribed devices. For example, to explain all the four parts, we will take example of magazine distribution. The Raspberry Pi Foundation publishes the Magpie magazine and the official Raspberry Pi project books through their website, and all the people who are interested in that magazine will subscribe to receive that magazine. In that example, the Raspberry Pi Foundation publishes different magazine on their website. The Raspberry Pi Foundation is the publisher. The Magpie and the official Raspberry Pi project books are the publication of Raspberry Pi Foundation, so they are topics, and the content inside them is the message. Their website is here acting as a broker, and the people who are getting these magazines on subscription are subscribers. To explain the network technology, we will consider four things: broker or cloud, devices, sensors, and actuators. Two devices are subscribing to topic temp, so when Nodemcu or ESP8266 will read data from temperature sensor, it will publish the temperature value on topic temp. The two devices which are subscribing to temp will receive that message. Similarly, there are two devices that are subscribing to topic gas. When second ESP will read data from gas sensor, it will publish the data to the topic gas, and the data will goes to cloud, which will decide on which devices to send the data, and the device which have already subscribed to gas will receive the gas value. Collectively, there are three end devices. One is subscribing to temp, another is subscribing to gas, and one is subscribing to both. So they will get messages accordingly. Hopefully this video helped you learn the basic of this protocol and you learned how this protocol works. If you find it helpful, please share it. Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more such tutorials.